Here's today's daily shoutouts. Congratulations, guys! If you guys want a chance to win a shoutout on my next video, just leave a nice comment down below. Also, be sure to hit that subscribe button and drop a like. And check out LissyNoelle.com for the merch.
Hey, guys! Welcome back to another video. Today, we're doing yet again another scary video for Halloween time, since you guys love these scary videos. Trixie, are you ready for another scary video? Yeah! Also, a lot of you guys have been asking why Trixie hasn't been in the recent videos. She got really sick and we just found out that she does have epilepsy. So I want to thank everybody who's been watching our videos recently because you guys have helped me fund Trixie's medical bills and all of her pills. She is doing quite a bit better. She had some pretty nasty seizures recently, but she's doing a lot better. So thank you guys for everybody who's been asking about how Trixie's doing. I know she missed being in the video. Drop a like if you guys agree Trixie's the cutest little doggo in the world. Anyways, guys, I found out today when I was researching online that one of the most haunted places in the entire USA is literally like 10 minutes from my house. Crazy, right? I've actually known this for a while since there's a lot of rumors about this place in my city. It's called the Kia Mill. So I found this article here and it says a dead girl in a blue dress haunts this abandoned mill in California. In 1918, a mill was built in Marietta, California. The Kia Mill successfully ran all the way through the 1970s. However, it is said that the mill had a fire and never fully recovered from the loss. The Kia Mill was boarded up in 1991. It's still boarded up right now. It's like all locked off. Today, it sits empty, save for the many spirits who are said to make it home now. That is creepy. It's actually a terrifying looking place. It doesn't look like a place you'd want to go to at 3 a.m. But I will put it out there. If this video gets to 20,000 likes, I will try to go there at 3 a.m. and do a scarier nighttime video. Right now, it's like 2:10 p.m. in the afternoon. It's not 3 a.m. It says that many locals believe that this place is haunted by a little girl who wears a blue dress. And many locals, I've even heard this rumor from my old high school, said that they have seen this girl sitting in the middle window of the Kia Mill, waving and then disappearing. And apparently, it's supposed to smell like lavender when you go outside. Apparently, they say lavender blows in the air and there is no lavender plants, so that's kind of scary. Someone named Mitchell said, I wasn't sure if this rumor was true. I wanted to find out myself. So I waited until it was dark and I snuck in with only a headlamp. The place is definitely eerie. So I could see how even looking at that on the outside building can simply create assumptions from others. I had to battle the urge to leave the moment that I got there. I took my time exploring, wondering where most people had seen the little girl in the dress that haunts this building. Is anybody there? I called out, hearing it echo all around. I wasn't sure if the girl would actually respond, but I figured it was worth a shot. And they put a picture of this girl that haunts the building. That's actually crazy. They have a picture of her. It's actually so sad. I think that girl might have passed away there on the property, so rest in peace to her. That is super sad. This person said, after about a minute or so, I thought I heard a faint giggle in the distance. It was distant, but I could tell it's coming from somewhere within the building. The sound made all the hairs on the back of my neck rise up. I was pretty much shaking in my boots. I gave myself a mental pep talk and forced myself to keep walking. I went up a couple flights of stairs, but each time I heard the giggle, it seemed like they were echoing from the exact place that I had left. So basically, it continues saying that this guy had seen what passed by a window very quickly, a flash of blue cloth, which is kind of creepy. I have the chills telling this story because this place literally scares me so much. It is definitely, in my opinion, haunted. I went there once at like 3 or 4 a.m. in the morning before, and we were going to film a video there. Me and my friends got so scared because we saw a car sitting on the side of the road and we thought we saw somebody in it.
There's even an abandoned car here with the windows.
Oh, someone's in there.
Oh,
yeah. Oh my God, my heart. Get okay, get out of here! What the f-? Did you see that?
No!
Light.
You guys are at this haunted place.
I don't like it here.
And look, hear this noise?
Dude, I want to die right now.
What's this place called again?
The Kia Mill, and I'm never coming back.
It's called the Kia Mill, one of the most haunted places.
And then we never went back. So I'm actually going to go investigate this building and take you guys to the Kia Mill right now. And we're going to take our rods and my haunted doll, Rose, and see if we can ask Rose if this place is haunted and see if we can capture anything during daylight that seems suspicious. So we're going to go check it out and see if the Kia Mill is really haunted. Let's go. So I'm in the car with my mom right now, and we are headed to this mill. I'm really kind of nervous because, like, this place actually scares me. That's why I'm going in daylight. But like I said, if this video gets to 20,000 likes, I will go back at nighttime to see if it's any different. But it's scary. I'm nervous. We're getting close, guys. I remember it's not this street, but I think it's this street. Yep, there it is. I can see it.
Oh my gosh. There's an old school over there too that's all burned down.
Yeah, it was burned down.
Yeah, that one's supposed to be haunted too. I don't even know the story to that, but I know the Kia Mill is haunted as well. But the old school is supposed to be really creepy as well, and they're all blocked off.
There's someone parked up by it.
I wonder if they're like people that come here often to look at the place because of all the like scary things. Yeah, there is someone parked outside of it. Maybe they live here. Oh, it's so creepy and big. Oh my gosh, last time I saw it, it was like dark outside. Now it's like light outside. And there was a car up there last time I came here and there was no one in it and it was so freaky. Oh my gosh, guys, so we are really here. There's a crow up there. Oh my gosh, there's a crow. Look at that. All the way at the very top. That's the first thing I see. There's a crow. I'm gonna try to zoom in on my little camera. I hope I can get that for you guys. I remember when I came here last time at night, there was a ton of birds. The weirdest thing about the crow though is it's been so still. It literally has not moved, like at all. And I noticed on the top there, it spells out Jesus. J-E-S-U-S. You know that's been there literally for years. And I think they do that to keep evil spirits out because this place is supposed to be seriously super creepy and dangerous. That's all I know. I think they do that to keep out evil spirits, putting Jesus's name on the building to kind of get rid of any demonic vibes. Also, I brought Rose since you guys missed her. We're gonna see what she has to say about this place. We're gonna ask her some questions with the rods today and the Necrophonic app. She might want to connect with the girl here who's supposed to haunt the building. I don't know how old the girl was. I think she was younger, but maybe she will like the doll. Maybe Rose will like her. So we're gonna see if my haunted doll can give us any answers about the Kia Mill today. And we're gonna walk around and see what else we can find out here. I wanna mention that there is a hole here within the gate, and if I wanted to, I could be a savage and be like, yo, I'm gonna break into the Kia Mill, but I really don't want to get arrested because I'm pretty sure trespassing a property like this is very illegal. I don't want to promote that on my channel, so stay safe, kids. There's a bush here and I heard something in it. Kids, you don't want to go into haunted possessed places. Even if it's daylight, you gotta stay safe. This place was burned down. There's a lot of fire markings on the building. It definitely, you can see how there was a fire here. So yeah, this place is very, very real. Very, very creepy. I don't get any bad vibes here yet, but I am gonna see if I can try to communicate to any spirits that might be here and find out more history by asking Rose, my haunted doll, about what might have happened here at the Kia Mill and stuff like that. I don't wanna break in and disrespect the property or any spirits in the property. Also, I want to mention there is apparently the haunted school that was also burnt down or something really creepy happened to it. That it might be a separate video. If you guys want me to film that abandoned burned down school, let me know. Kind of scared of that. I don't know much about it, but it is across the street from this very giant scary mill. Okay guys, so these right here are dowsing rods. These right here are used to communicate to spirits. They actually will cross for yes and open wide for no when we ask a question. So I'm going to start off by asking a question about the mill and see if there's any spirits currently with us. So I'm going to hold the rods up very still. So I'm going to ask if there's anyone here with us right now, can you please cross the rods? That was so fast. That was so fast, guys. Okay. Are you the little girl who wears the blue dress? Yes. Rose the doll, who's currently on the ground. Show them. She's currently with us. I'm going to ask if she is present as well. Rose, if you are with us, can you cross the rod? Oh! Okay, can you open the rods, please? Thank you. So we have Rose with us and the girl in the blue dress at the same time. I'm going to ask Rose some questions. I'm going to see if I can use the Necrophonic app. Since these are really active, maybe I should try to ask one more question. Rose, are you and the girl with the blue dress going to be good friends? Yes! Okay, that's good. The girl in the blue dress, are you happy to have us here today to visit you? Yes, okay, well that's good. They like the company here. So they are present with us according to the rods, but we're going to try to use the Necrophonic app to see if they want to speak with their voice. This app actually will let them use the app to use their actual voice to communicate with us, which is crazy, guys. Don't try this at home. Okay, so I have Rose here with us, and we're going to see if she or the girl in the blue dress wants to communicate through the Necrophonic app or Necrophonic. I don't know if I'm saying it right, but we're gonna hit start here. Girl, if you're here, can you tell us your name, girl in the blue dress? Daisy? Is your name Daisy? Yes again, I heard yes again. So Daisy, you are the girl in the blue dress? Yes or no? I heard yes again. Rose, if you're here, can you say Rose? I heard no. And no again. Wait, did that say Rose? If you're here, where are we at? Can you say the name of where we are right now? Where are we? I heard it say the mill! I heard it say the mill! Oh my gosh, no! No! I got chills all over my body. It said the mill in a very clear voice. Did you hear that, Mom?
Yeah, I did. That's creepy.
It said the mill. And it said it so fast. I cannot make this up. It literally said the mill. I'm gonna have to play that back. It said the mill. And it said it so fast, right? Am I crazy?
No, you're not. It did say the mill. That's creepy.
Very creepy. My gosh. Okay, I'm gonna ask who said that though. Can you say your name? So your name is Daisy, right? She said hi. Is that Daisy that I just heard say hi in a girl voice? John? Wait, I heard the name John as well. John, are you here as well? Hello, you said hello. So we have a Daisy and we have a John here. All right, can you tell us one more time, where are we at? Yeah, can you tell us where we are one more time? Where are we? Do you know the name of the place we are right now? What is behind me? What is this building called? Did it say the mill again? The mill. Okay, I'm going to exit out of the app. I feel like they're kind of shy to talk to us. We did get some answers. We got the mill, we got John, we got Daisy. So basically what we got out of this was Rose was too shy to talk right now. She didn't even talk to us here. For some reason, she only used the rods, but they did say that we have John and Daisy here at the mill. I'm not sure if John and Daisy are connected. I'm going to have to do some research when I get home to see if anyone named John or Daisy was here at the mill before, but those are the two spirits that came through on the Negrophonic app. Might still be here today, guys. They wanted to say hi to us today. It's so crazy, guys, like thinking about that this was once an active running mill, and the bird is still up there. I'm gonna see if I can try to get a better view of the bird for you guys. What is that on the ground right there? I do not know. But see that? The bird that sits at the window? I think there was something online saying that sometimes ghosts will disguise themselves as birds up at the top of this mill, and they will dive down, and when they're diving down, you can hear a young girl screaming and falling, which is really scary, because that might have been how one of the girls did die during the fire at the mill, falling from the top of the building, which is super sad. And that guy has been up there at the top of the mill for a while now, and I haven't seen anything suspicious in the windows up there yet, or seen or heard anything scary, but I bet at night this place is probably a lot more active, especially at 3 a.m. So let me know if you guys would like me to come back here and film another video here about the mysteries of the mill at night. At night, it gets super dark out here because there is no lights on the street, so I've been kind of avoiding it. I would definitely have to do it with some friends at 3 a.m. and further investigate it a little more. But let me know in the comments down below, do you guys think this place is haunted? And if you guys have any ghost stories that are scary, type them down below in the comments. And I will see you guys next time. Bye, guys! So that was it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you guys enjoyed, be sure to hit the subscribe button, be sure to drop a like, and be sure to leave a comment down below. I will see you guys next time. Goodbye.